Hi, welcome back to a new section. Here you learn how to build chatbots. Let me show you an example of a chatbot that you'll build during this section. I've built it already, so I'm going to show you the output only, and then we build the code step by step. So I'm going to run this. The chatbot greets me and he or she is asking me a question. What do I want to know? Now, this particular chatbot knows about vegetables. So it is specialized about a topic, and you can ask the chatbot questions such as, can you eat vegetables? And the chatbot will answer you this. So that's the answer. And the chatbot gets this answer from a Wikipedia article about vegetables. So that is the corpus where this chatbot gets the knowledge from. Let's ask another question. Are there vitamins? Oh, careful with the typos. In vegetables. And we get this answer. The nutritional content of vegetables varies considerably. Some contains amounts of protein and so on. So it also talks about vitamins, as you see in here. And so on. If you ask an off-topic question, of course, the chatbot, can you eat Facebook? The chatbot will say, I don't know. And if you type in quit, the chatbot will quit. So let's build this exact chatbot in this video. I'm going to close this window and open a new one. So let me clear that. I'm going to start from this code, not from scratch. And I'm going to do that because we already built this code in the previous section of the course. So if you don't know what this code is about, you have to follow the previous section, particularly the last video, which covers the topic of finding the most similar sentence. So this is the exact code that we built in that video. However, if you don't want to watch that video, I'll explain this code quickly now. So what we've got here is we import the NLTK library, which is used for natural language processing, and we import the scikit-learn library. We need a couple of objects from that, which we'll use later on down here. Then we download some datasets which contain words and phrases in English. So the chatbot needs this information to be able to understand the questions that we ask, that the user asks. And then we got this text here, so that is a corpus, the knowledge currently of the chatbot. We're going to replace that with content from a Wikipedia article. You'll see how we do that. And then we have this question here, what are plans? Then we created a lemmatizer instance in here, a lemma function which converts the words of a sentence. It converts the words into lemmas. For example, if the word is are or is, the lemma of that is be. So it finds out the root of the words given a sentence. So it returns a list of lemmas. Afterwards, we tokenize the text. So we make a list of sentences. So this sentence tokens will be a list of three items because we have three sentences. So each item is a string representing one of the sentences. And then we append the question. So that question, we append it to that list. So from a list of three items, we end up with a list of four items. Then we apply the algorithm which finds a coefficient which denotes the importance of each word in that text plus the question. So it attaches a coefficient to each word to denote the importance of the words, and then it finds a similarity between the last sentence, which is the question, and the entire text. So it finds out the similarity between the question and each of the sentences. And then we sort it out by the coefficient value. So the greatest coefficient means there's more similarity. So we sort it out and we find the index that has the maximum coefficient. And then if the coefficient is greater than 0.3, then we return from that list of sentences, we return the list that has that index, the index that points to the sentence with the highest coefficient. So basically we're calculating, we are finding out the sentence between these three, the sentence that is the most similar to the question. So that's how we find the answer. If I run that, you see that this is a sentence that the program chose as the best answer for this question. What are plants? Vegetables are all plants. Or what are vegetables? And I expect to get the same answer. So that, and maybe another question. Can you eat vegetables? Run. I expect to get this as an answer this time. Yes, that's the case. So it's working. Now let's turn this program into an interactive chatbot that gets questions. It waits for questions from us and it returns answers. It asks us again and so on. To implement that interactivity, what we need to do is go down here and implement a while loop that runs all the time and it asks us a question of, hi, what do you want to know? And I'll add a backslash n to make a break line after this question. So it's an input function. If I run this, you'll see how this changes the output. So we get the answer first from the program and then we get this question. Hi, what do you want to know? So if we enter a question, can you eat vegetables? Nothing will happen. The chatbot will keep asking questions because that's what this while loop does. It iterates all the time. It executes this over and over again. So instead of letting this loop iterate, we want to add something else in here. We want to send this question to the algorithm for processing. However, we cannot do that given the structure of the code. So what we need to do is we need to put all this code where we tokenize a sentence and where we append the question to the sentence tokenized list. So we need to indent that. I selected it and I pressed tab and I put it in a function, define process. So that is a function. The role, the purpose of this function is to get the text, tokenize it, add the question to the text, and then find the similarity between the question and the text. So it's processing the question and the text. Therefore, it makes sense to have two parameters, text and question. Therefore, let me put the colon there. Therefore, now we can do something like the output is equal to process. So that function, we call that function. The text will be equal to the text variable. So text is this parameter name, and text, the second text, is this variable which contains the corpus. So that parameter is equal to that big string there, and same for the question. Question is equal to question. You can also just leave it like that, text and question, and it's basically the same thing. So we get the output. But this function is not returning anything yet. It prints out something, but it's not a return statement. So you want to convert that into a return statement instead of print. So now this piece of code here is equal to that, and that returns the best sentence that matches the question. So output is the best sentence, the most similar sentence now. Therefore, what we can do is print out the output. Stop and run again. Hi, what do you want to know? Can you eat vegetables? Vegetables can be eaten either raw or cooked. So it's working. It got the best answer from this text, which makes sense. Yeah, that one. So that means we don't need this static declaration here because we are getting the question from the user now. So delete that. And what else can we add here? Well, sometimes you can ask, the user can ask irrelevant questions such as, you have Facebook? And you get none. We get none because this question, this sentence does not have a coefficient of greater than 0.3. So what happens in that case is this function will return a none object. So that is the equivalent of saying else return none. So whether you write this part or not, the function will still return none, even if you don't write this part. Therefore, we can say if output, then print out the output. So if output means if the output is not none. If it's none, this will not be executed. So this is the equivalent of saying if output is different from none, then you execute that. But this is more Pythonic. If output, then print output. And I would also like to add something. If question is equal to quit. So if the user enters quit, quit will be saved in the question variable. So if it's quit, then we break the loop, the while loop, and the program ends. Else print I don't know. So we have three scenarios: when the output exists, when the user entered quit, or when the output doesn't exist. So there is not a similar question to that question. What do you want to know? Can you eat vegetables? The chatbot answers us with this. And then it asks again the same question. Hi, what do you want to know? Well, how can I fix my pants zipper? The chatbot doesn't know that, of course, so we get that. And lastly, let's try quit, and the program quits. Now, we're working so far on this limited text here. So how can we replace that with the content from a Wikipedia article? We can do that by importing Wikipedia. That is a third-party library, and then instead of text you say Wikipedia dot page. What page do you want to have here? Vegetables. So this chatbot knows about vegetables. You can also find ways to make this dynamic, so to ask the user first what topic they want to know about, and then you enter that topic in here as a string, and then you start the conversation again. What do you want to know about that topic that the user chose? But for this, let's keep it simple and just talk about vegetables. So vegetables.content, that will give you the Wikipedia content about vegetables stored in the text variable. So now we can talk about more things with our chatbot. Let's see. What do you want to know? Are there vitamins in vegetables? and we get this answer, which is about vitamins. So it's something that the chatbot gets from the Wikipedia article, of course. And some people may find it limited. The best would be to get a very, very accurate answer for this, like yes or no, or yes, there are vitamins. But I think this is still very good. So it's quite an accurate match given the sentences you find in the Wikipedia articles of vegetables. So all that content is used by the chatbot. So that concludes this video. I thank you for following and I'll talk to you later.